amendments, including a ban on military assault weapons and limits on high-capacity ammunition, but those amendments are expected to fail in the deeply divided Senate. Philadelphia's chief medical examiner is testifying about nearly 50 frozen babies removed from an abortion doctor's clinic. Sam Zanino told the jury at Colonel Dinesnell's murder trial that he had to examine the contents of plastic bags containing the aborted babies. Investigators found their remains inside a freezer at Dinesnell's Philadelphia clinic. He is charged with killing 7 babies born alive and could be hostage for death. The United States Supreme Court will not get involved in a case stemming from a New York gun law. BLM requires a person who wants to carry a concealed handgun to have a special reason before their national license. You might have to get BLM violates the Second Amendment. The nation's high court could take up the case at another time. A ruling against football helmet maker Goodell could bolster a separate case brought by thousands of former NFL players. A Colorado jury found the company failed to properly warn players about the potential risk of concussions. The company was ordered to pay more than $3 million to a 22-year-old who was left partially paralyzed from a football injury when he was 17. And Major League Baseball is celebrating Jackie Robinson Day. Today is the 66th anniversary of Robinson breaking baseball's color barrier with the Brooklyn Dodgers in 1947. He will be honored in all 9 ballparks where games will be played today. Players throughout the league will wear Robinson's number 42, which was permanently retired throughout baseball in 1997. Only New York Yankees closer Mariano Rivera still wears number 42 full-time, as it had not yet been retired when Rivera first began playing. And now your fascinating fact for the day. The monkey wrench is named after its inventor, a London blacksmith named Charles Monkey. Reporting for Ave Maria Radio News, I'm Nick Scott.